I'm saying goodbye. Mom, I'll see you again.
Defensive-minded hockey. Many games are hard-fought, and offensive players will need to take advantage of their opportunities. Time and space is at a premium. The D won't be giving up a lot of it. The Oilers have the first possession. It's all on his shoulders. Score! Boy, they're on the board early, aren't they? We knew the scoreless tie would be broken. Who thought this early? And by the visitor.
Boy, the visitor's got to gain a lot of confidence getting this early lead.
And that's a face-off win.
Scored by number 27.
Watch on that.
Assisted by number 25.
They take that neutral zone face off.
By number 74.
A shot.
By number 27.
Neely.
And by number 25. Darnell. Time of the goal. 59 seconds.
Edmonton's got that faceoff win. No team worth its name is going to let that go.
The Mares is not.
So, as
predicted. We have a fight here.
All players have a role, Doc. Two things, accept and execute. We certainly did that.
I can't say I was exactly ready for this. I was actually through a drink of water. That was going back into old times for those two major penalties.
This is the game from yesteryear. Strap your helmets on, get your sweaters buttoned down. There's been lots of fights, and I don't think this is going to stop anytime soon.
A little over 3 minutes have elapsed here in the first. Edmonton's just running up the score now. They have a four-goal advantage. Wow, that's got to be a call. That's got to be a penalty. We've got a man hurt here and probably something more to happen after.
The first concern is the injured player, Doc. Somebody has to respond.
There's really no reason for these guys to be dropping the glove.
5 minutes apiece for fighting. The way they went, they should have gotten jammed.
You almost forget that they're going to keep track of the game by score here. The players seem to want to settle a score on every whistle.
This period's become a mess for them. Somebody had to do something to try and change the momentum.
Just a hair over 4 minutes played here in the first. Momentum has shifted in this game. Another goal, and the advantage is four. Put his ground and block that shot. Look out, the hits are coming.
Was that who I thought hit him?
To Neely.
The Oilers have been a little bit lucky here.
Can he beat him here?
Now.
Looking to make something happen from behind. Shot! That shot came from right in front.
The shooter thought it was over, but the goaltender rocks a foot shot.
So you always want to finish your check, and if you have a position to deliver a real solid lick, you're going to take it. But man, he goes down hard here.
Get the ball. Craig's been doing it all tonight.
Even though he's really banged up.
done all he can do on this play. He tries to make a desperation dive back on the play. It's a great effort, but it's just not good enough.
A little under 7 minutes still showing on the clock this period. Edmonton's just piled on the score here, and so their statistics will be impressive by the end of the night. Huge, great white length save by number 27.
That is a great display of motion there behind the goal.
Almost another 3 seconds. And mercifully, play is stopped, and first aid can arrive.
Oh, that is a solid check. As soon as he moves into position to deliver it, he lays the hit on Harmon.
The Oilers prevail again. Puck ricochet off the screen. And decides to just hold on. Let's check in at ice level with Ray.
The Bears won't be able to get back into the game. He's out for the rest of the night. His injury will preclude him from playing today.
Edmondson's quick on the draw. That was one. He'll get the number off.
Oh, I like that one. That's a clean hit. Stoner's down after that hit.
Oh, he just keeps adding to a miserable night with another goal. Inside the final minute of the period. A terrific first period for one squad, but not for the other. So at least one coach has his hands full. We turn to the shots on goal. Heavy totals for one, very light for the other. 21 for Edmonton and 1 for the Coyotes.
Hey fans, now is the time to pick up your team calendar.
Arizona's goaltender has had one of those nights, and so this score is lopsided, and we will return after he gets a rest and these words. One period down, another period beckons here. What did you think of the first? The Coyotes
are trailing on the scoreboard because their time on attack was limited. They'll need to push the pace if they want to score more goals.
Second period is underway. It could be like the first, or it could be altogether different, a different chapter in the book. That's why we're here to watch it all. The Oilers are carrying it in their own zone. Is able to move on in. He's in! Solid work there by Lucic. Covers and holds on. Hey, Ray, what's going on down there?
Word from the home team's locker room is they're going to be short a player for the rest of the night. The injury occurred a while ago. He will not return.
They score! goals to show for their effort.
He's done it again. That's another victory in the big one.
Conservative. He's got that. enormous lead, and we're still in the second period.
Oilers goal, his third of the game, scored by number 27, Milan Lucic, assisted by number 14, led by number 75,
shot board. 47 for Edmonton, 4 for the Coyotes.
The fan
Arizona's workforce could be affected for the next period. We'll find out whether this injury has taken someone off the ice for the rest of the game or not.
Barcode on your ticket demo to earn points for attending tonight's game.
third period about to begin. The rearview mirror will help us with the first two, and so will Edson.
Edmonton's performance has been stellar coming into the third. I would expect more of the same rather than trying to protect the lead against a desperate hockey.
Third period is underway, and a game that has become lopsided, but it isn't over yet. Bang! Big hit! Possession gone! Well, that can settle this. What a save! I was looking for the lightning zone. Good work up front on that hit. Huge hit! Shuts that offense right off. Edmonton's back in his own end, trying to work forward. He gains the zone. Save! A punishing hit shuts that one down. Grabs it. Score! He's got his second of the game.
To the forehand and put it in.
A lot of times, as soon as the guy goes to shoot the puck, the goaltender drops into the butterfly position. He thinks he's got the net covered. Turns out he doesn't.
Edmonton's goal has built an even bigger lead. We're in the third period. For the opposition, at least that is fortunate. Directed to Hemsky. To the backhand.
The pad came in handy that time.
We go down to the benches. It's Ray Ferraro.
Thanks, guys. This has been a wonderful night for him. Every time he's had the puck, he's been able to find open ice, and whenever he's had the puck, it's not stayed on his stick very long.
It is just another in a long line of outstanding games for him, Ray.
We'll take a look back at his night. It's been perfect from his delivery of the puck to his teammates. Always flat, always in the right place at the right time.
He's been impossible to miss out there, Ray.